Welcome back to Anatomy Dissected by Complete Anatomy. We're still making our way through all of our cranial nerves, but this time we're going to focus on cranial nerve 6, the abducens nerve. As we've done with some of our previous videos, we'll start this one off by first exploring the pathway of this nerve. Then we'll examine the muscle it innervates and its function, and finally finish off by looking at some of the clinical correlates. Cranial nerve 6 is responsible for the innervation of the lateral rectus muscle. The abducens nerve arises from the abducens nucleus in the pons of the brainstem. In this visual, you can see that the pons has been faded. The axons of motor neurons emerge from the brainstem between the pons and the medulla oblongata. The nerve then runs forward and superiorly along the surface of the clivus within the subarachnoid space. It pierces the dura as it arches forward directly over the petrous part of the temporal bone, passing through the medial wall of the inferior petrosal sinus and running into the cavernous sinus, both of which have been faded here. In the cavernous sinus, the abducens nerve lies lateral to the internal carotid artery. This is unlike many of the other cranial nerves we have already looked at, which merely invaginate the lateral dura wall of the sinus. Upon exiting the sinus, the abducens nerve leaves the cranium via the superior orbital fissure within the common tendinous ring. Within the bony orbit, the abducens nerve then terminates by innervating the medial surface of the lateral rectus muscle. The abducens nerve is a purely somatic motor nerve, meaning it has no sensory function. Its main function is to carry general somatic efferent nerve axons to innervate the lateral rectus muscle, which is responsible for lateral movement of the eyeball. In this instance, lateral movement of the eyeball will move the eye away from the midline, or abduct it. This is where the abducens nerve gets its name. Given the complex course of the abducens nerve, there are quite a number of places where it is vulnerable to damage. Intracranial pressure can be elevated in conditions such as hydrocephalus and a space-occupying lesion, leading to the nerve becoming compressed along its course. Raised intracranial pressure is often associated with characteristic symptoms such as headache and drowsiness. However, symptoms of cranial nerve 6 palsy are also exhibited. These may include horizontal diplopia, where an individual is unable to abduct the affected eye and gaze laterally. Additionally, strabismus may also occur. This often occurs as the nerve passes over bony structures such as the clivus and the petrous part of the temporal bone. Due to its location deep within the cavernous sinus, the nerve may also become compressed as a result of cavernous sinus thrombosis or an internal carotid artery aneurysm. And so we reach the end of our video on cranial nerve 6. Hopefully at this stage you are now familiar with the path of the nerve, from the abducens nucleus to the lateral rectus muscle. You understand the function of the muscle this nerve innervates, and you are aware of some causes and symptoms of abducens nerve damage. If you're interested in learning about the rest of the cranial nerves, be sure to stay tuned. And don't forget to hit the like button below and subscribe to our channel for more top class anatomy content.